name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with you all.
Amen.
In the waters of baptism, our Saint died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May she now share with him the eternal life. She was given a new white garment, a symbol of her new life in Jesus Christ. Queen of Christ's garment, body, the coffin, reminding us all our life, death, and resurrection in Jesus Christ. Place it now on the coffin of the sun. and live.
Amen.
For reflection on our singer's life, as Joshua, please come forward, congregation, may be seated.
I had a hard time putting all of Marcy's good traits into writing. No matter how hard I tried the past 2 days, I can never do justice to who she was and what she created and overcame in her life. I know we are grieving today for we lost a magnificent woman, but we are here to grieve together. No matter how sad it is important to remember to celebrate her and what she did for us, no matter how big or how small. It would be completely arrogant of me, but as you all know, not beyond me, to come up here and try to sum up 95 years of life by Marcine. A life that included worldly events that were sad, scary, happy, and even hopeful. More importantly, there were so many personal events that only she could tell us about. I want to talk about just what I know. She came from a family of 14, graduated high school and from business college at a time when most women weren't encouraged or thought in a proper place to do so. Got married, had 10 kids, and created this big, loving family that includes 19 grandchildren and 20 great-grandchildren. As we all know, love brings loss, and Marcine certainly had her share. To live without your husband for 40-plus years and to be two people for 10 kids takes unfathomable individual strength, personal sacrifice, courage, and mental resolve. And she did it all along with grace, calm, and a smile. No parent wants to outlive their children, and she unfortunately lost 3 of hers to tragic ends. I don't bring this up to dwell on the negative, but to remind us all that she lived. She persevered with dedication and love. Dedication and love to her family and anyone that was in her life. I like to believe that she could suffer great sorrow because she was a person that was capable of loving so strongly. I just want to come up here and say thank you. Thank you for living your life and being you, because you were such a huge part in shaping the good in so many of us here. Thank you for being a role model on how to work hard, to love unconditionally, to listen, to laugh, and as a boy and as a man, how to respect and love the women in my life. Thank you for showing us that a single mom can raise 10 kids, work a job, and create a loving family atmosphere that we're all so proud to be a part of. Thank you for the Sunday dinners that became routine in my life and created a family pride and joy that always made me feel that nobody I knew had a more fun, supportive, loving, interesting family. Thank you for being in every game I ever played and for wearing my number with such pride that it always put a smile on my face and hugged my heart. Thank you for always having your door open to all of us at various times when we needed a place to stay and call home. No matter how short or how long, we were always welcome. Thank you for teaching us about the 7 fishes, your homemade Christmas cookies, Thanksgiving dinners, Christmas Eve celebrations, and grinding my head that getting together, supporting one another with love is what family does. The kind of love Grandma felt for us was a love without condition. She may not have approved of everything any of us did, may not like some of the decisions we all made, and God knows her love for her badness. But she didn't lecture, she didn't judge, she just kept loving us and supporting us, letting us know that she was there if we ever needed her. Death ends a life, but not a relationship. The relationship I have with Grandma gone and me forever, and I thank her for that.
Happy history of saints. Give, we pray, your servant Marcine, whom today we perform these funeral rites for, a share in the chosen, with the chosen ones and those who are blessed, so that on the day of resurrection, free from the bonds of mortality, she may come before you face to face. We pray this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
For our first reading from the book of Ecclesiastes, please be seated.
Thank you. In them we have died with Christ. We believe that we shall also live with him. We know that Christ, raised from the dead, dies no more. Death no longer has power over him. The word of the Lord.
To be so successful at life, tribute in itself. A person like Marcin, to be able to manage so many things and to be able to still be understood and as having time for someone else. Time to give love to someone else. Time to give patience to someone else. Time to give understanding. That is a tribute. When you just think about it, in this church, 10 times she came for baptism for these children. 10 times she instructed them in the reception of the body and blood of Jesus Christ, the Holy Eucharist, having them to understand that from this altar they receive not just bread and wine, but the real flesh and body, flesh and blood, that is Jesus Christ, our Savior. 10 times she would have to go over those 10 commandments, precepts of the church, and helping a child to learn to make their first reconciliation, their first confession, with grace and dignity, joy and love. For everything there is a season. If you take each day as it comes along, those seasons pass almost without notice. But what will never pass without notice is the love and affection that you give to others. Certainly the gathering here today witnesses to the love that they were given, to them that now is a sorrow in their life, because one who loved them has been taken, has gone before her. Let us rise and offer our prayer. God the Almighty Father, who raised Christ the Son from the dead, with confidence we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For Marcin, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our sister who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on that last day, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of her sister, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend, Lazarus, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Those who trusted in the Lord now speak to the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all those whose faith is known to you alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our deceased relatives and friends, and for all those who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
and grant them fullness of redemption. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Please be seated.
Please join us in singing number 435, Be Not Afraid, number 435.
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant, my seed. We beseech your mercy, that she who did not doubt your son to be a merciful Savior may find in him hope, to merciful judge, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Lord, be with you. Always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of the resurrection has died, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When the body of our earthly dwelling lies in dust, we gain an eternal dwelling in heaven. And so with all the angels, the archangels, the thrones, the dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end, we acclaim. May he make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, and all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for our unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your global church on earth, your servant Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, and for your bishops and all the clergy and the entire people who have gained for your home. Listen graciously to the prayers of the family you have summoned you before you. In your compassion and mercy, Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Marcin, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who is united with your son in death like his, may also be one with him in the resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up into flesh those who have died and transform our bodies after the pattern of his glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their passing, give kind returns to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For on seeing you are God as you are, we shall be like you for all ages, and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, who will bestow on the world all that is good.
Thank you.
of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my house, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Son left us his sacrament, his body and blood, food for the church. Mercifully granted, strengthened by it, our sister Maxine may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Trusting in God, we have prayed together from our seat. We now come to our last farewell. There is sadness of heart, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see her again and enjoy her friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in his kingdom. Therefore, we console one another with our faith in Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
we who mourn be reunited one day with our Savior. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, when he who is our life appears in glory. Paul writes to the Philippians and says, "My citizenship is in heaven, and from it we await the Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ." Lord Jesus Christ, by your own 3 days in the tomb, you made holy the graves of all who believe in you. And so may the grave a sign of hope that promises resurrection, even as it claims our mortal bodies. Grant that our sister may sleep here in peace until you awaken her to glory. For you are the resurrection of the life. Then she will see you face to face, and in your light see light, and know the splendor of God, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Because Almighty God has chosen to call our saint from himself to himself, we commit her body to the earth. We are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory, for he is risen, the firstborn of the dead. So let us commend our sister to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace her in peace and raise her up on the last day. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant, Marcine. Do not count her deeds against her, for in her heart she desired to do you a